Hello everyone. Today we are here back, and as I had hoped not, but you know what has happened is the fears are coming true, and the coronavirus outbreak in India is increasing on an exponential rate. As we know, and from what is reported officially, I'm not going to go on unofficial accounts, but the official count is that in there's a bunch of you know, group of 20 travelers who were Italian, who at least one of them was carrying coronavirus, and this is the case which we talked about yesterday. And these Italian travelers apparently visited Agra and then went to Jaipur, and then this one person was of course detected and separated and has probably been in quarantine now. But the remaining 19 people were for about 3-4 days out there in the streets of Delhi, probably visiting other monuments. And there is a chance that some of those 19 people who have been roaming in the streets of Delhi were exposed to this one person who is a coronavirus case, might be carriers of the coronavirus, and they have already spent a few days in the streets of Delhi, unwittingly might have infected many other people. And the reason I really fear about these 19 people who have not been quarantined for many days and they went around the streets of Delhi was because of the case of that one particular person who came in an Air India flight and who's now been quarantined, who was in one of the hospitals. But this person apparently went to his family, and his entire family is now showing signs of viral infection, possibly coronavirus. An accountant who used to work in his company is also showing signs of coronavirus, and his family, media is reporting, the accountant's family is also showing signs of coronavirus infection. There was another family which this person met who happens to be living in Noida. That family is also now showing signs of coronavirus infection. And as a precautionary measure, thankfully, that particular school where this children from, where the child of this family, the Noida family, was living, that child's school has been shut down. But of course, a few days have passed without, you know, us noticing that. That was very important. That is the reason it was extremely important to stop this virus. There was only one way to cure this virus, and that is to prevent it. And that apparently we tried to do our best perhaps, but the virus is with us. As of now, the infection has spread in, of course, in Delhi. It has gone to Noida. It has probably been traveled to Jaipur and Agra because of that Italian travel group. It has gone to Bangalore. It has gone to Hyderabad, because the Hyderabad techie who had this virus had traveled with that virus from Bangalore to Hyderabad. Now, it's very important what we should do now, because what's happened is happened, but I think what we should do now is immediately track all these people and all those other people these people have met. So it's important, for instance, to track what cabs this Hyderabad techie would have taken, or what bus he took. And this information should be out in public so that anybody else who has traveled with the same bus, the same cab, even after he has traveled, because the coronavirus, if he coughed or sneezed in that cab, those seats and those handles, everything would have been infected for a few days. And anybody who traveled in that particular cab number for the next 2 or 3 days is a potential case of coronavirus. It's extremely important now to be, this is the biggest emergency we need to deal with immediately. This is the most urgent issue which we need to deal with. I know some of you are taking questions. Hello to everyone who said hi, but there's some questions which I'll also take. But before that, there were some previous questions which had come, and some good suggestions who had come, which I want to take up. And these had come on my Facebook, and I'm going to read off my other phone some of these questions, and I'll try to, you know, we've researched a bit on it. I also sort of advise you to take medical advice from your doctor. But from some of these questions are fairly widely answered in other places where coronavirus has already been found, and we'll take them, a few of them at least. Abhishek Singh has asked me a question that, sir, I have a small query. Like most of the virus, will this novel coronavirus cannot survive? Will this would not be able to survive with the increase in the ambient? So he's basically saying if the ambient temperature, which is if summers come in, would coronavirus sort of not be as effective? So let me tell you this. Let's understand why do viruses, most viruses are unable to travel or infect too quickly when there's heat or humidity. And the reason for that is that viruses cannot. So most of viruses are traveling through, respiratory droplets, things which, infected patients sneeze or cough, and that droplet, small tiny droplets, are the ones which infect the environment around them. So that is the aerosol-based contamination of air. Usually, it affects to a distance of about 3 feet. So, see what happens is in summers and in humid climates, the aerosol droplets cannot travel long distances. They cannot remain suspended in the air because, because of the summer, I mean, of course, they can evaporate, or because of humidity, they can drop down immediately. So the infection rate goes down. Now, that's a good news. But the bad news is that coronavirus has also got two brothers. Now, one is called the MERS, which happened in Middle East respiratory syndrome. And then there was SARS, which is the severe acute respiratory syndrome. Now, both of these viruses, which are of the same family of viruses as coronavirus, the novel coronaviruses, there is no evidence to suggest that they would die down in summer. In fact, MERS survived through a good summer. It was not at all seasonal. And SARS, as we know, suddenly collapsed in the month of July, which was humid. So, if SARS is the path which novel coronavirus is going to take, then you'll have to wait for rains. And if, in all likelihood, if it goes like the MERS, then I don't think we should, that should not be something which you rely on as a prevention. So don't bank on weather to save you, weather to save us from infection. We have to fight this infection, assuming that, like MERS and like other coronavirus families, this summers are not going to significantly have an impact on anything to do with coronavirus. The other problem in India is that we have a severe issue of diabetes. And diabetes, in another video which I'll be posting, my team is manufacturing, producing that video. Diabetes cases, respiratory diseases, and cardiac, if infected, already people who have pre-existing condition of all either diabetes, respiratory, or cardiac, are extremely prone to the mortality which happens out of coronavirus. So things can get complex for these kind of people. And not just the two age groups which we have been talking, the very young and the very old, but also people with diabetes, respiratory, and cardiac issues are very susceptible to coronavirus becoming extremely severe in them. And that is, we are the diabetes capital of the world. So we have to be very sure, and especially a place like Delhi, Noida, because of the pollution, respiratory disorder, especially in children, is very high. So we have to be very cautious not to become a basket case of coronavirus. Let me take some more questions and then I'll take those live questions. Prashant Baliga has actually given a very good suggestion, and I actually followed up on that suggestion. And Prashast Baliga. He says that Singapore government has created an official WhatsApp subscription, and he has sent me a snap of the WhatsApp subscription. You can find that snap in the post just before this video. Where in this WhatsApp group by the government, it's an official WhatsApp group. Singapore government is informing its citizens of all the whereabouts on coronavirus and how it is spreading and what they are doing to stop it. I think it's a great idea. In fact, I can't recall who said it, but somebody commented in a previous post to me that they tried to dial the coronavirus helpline and nobody answered. Now, that is a bit worrisome because I think if we do not answer people on the coronavirus helpline, then who will? So I think governments need to get serious to talk about coronavirus. And I think broadcasting coronavirus over a WhatsApp is a very good idea because it's difficult to handle individual cases one on a case-by-case basis. But we can definitely, create a WhatsApp group or a social media group. In fact, I really requested the Prime Minister today to not, go off social media, but, dedicate the social media for the next 2, 3 months to fight coronavirus. He's got such a fantastic following and people respect and, listen to his word and, in a way, sort of, it's a verified information by the Prime Minister. I really suggested to him today on Twitter that you don't go off, any social media. You should rather use it to fight this coronavirus. We will need your social media to do that. Then, sorry, coughing is a dangerous sign. So, Kamal Kannan from Bahrain replied. He sent me an. He's from Bahrain, and as you know, Bahrain is seeing about 48 infections so far. It's a very small country. The population is only a few million. And it's saying 41 infections. So it's a very serious issue in Bahrain. But what has happened in Bahrain, what the government has done is noteworthy, very important, and India should do that too. First of all, schools have been shut down for 2 weeks. I have been calling this from all governments to shut down all schools immediately. It has to be immediate. Like from tomorrow, we should do this. Should just send out a notification that summer vacations have started and we'll tell you when it ends. But children must be protected. And I'm actually very sad that none, even the state governments or the central government, nobody's responding to the cause of our future. We are exposing our children to this virus. There's nothing more important than protecting your children from this. So it's just, I mean, I hope we do it tomorrow. It just makes me really wonder. I mean, we should just end it. And the other thing I'm very concerned about is we have a big festival of Holi coming up. And in this festival of Holi, you know, people gather and people are extremely close to each other. There is, it's a festival of water, and it just makes the whole basket case of virus go up. We have to tackle the issue of what to do with Holi because Holi is coming in. It's nothing to do with religion, it's to do with the fact that we have to protect everybody. So the biggest festival coming in where people get close. I've seen how, Holi is played all over India. It's a fantastic festival. But this time we must control it down because you cannot allow some big social gatherings happening. Now I'll come back to what Kamal Kanan told me about Bahrain. Bahrain has done the following thing. Schools have been shut down for 2 weeks, and that's where I sort of digressed. Public gatherings have been completely banned. Government has, and this is a very important one, third one. Government has released a list of names of immigrants, people who have come from outside, from countries like Iran, and Iran is highly infected by the virus, by the way. And strict orders have been given for those who have come from Iran to come and test for the virus, right? And then they have set up a building for quarantine, which is far from city. Now that's very important because from what I know from news, the Delhi coronavirus case is in Safdarjung Hospital, which is right in the middle of the town. Like it's 3 kilometers from the Prime Minister's house. It's about 1 kilometer from where I am right now. So it's very important to not put quarantine patients in public hospitals because there are people with less immunity who are coming to hospitals and they are the most prone cases. Somebody who's coming up with a severe respiratory problem anyways is susceptible to the virus. And now you're putting a person who is infected with the virus in that same building. He's going to use the same elevator. People from the hospital staff are going to, be also around this person. And I don't want the infection to start spreading to people who are anyways sick. And because they are the basket cases, healthy people are relatively safe in terms of mortality from coronavirus, but unhealthy people, old people are not. And these people you'll find in hospitals. So that is a very good suggestion, which Bahrain government has done it. And a far away facility is being set up. China also did that. And Iran missed that. So Iran had a huge mortality issue of this thing. Now I'm going to take some questions from. Let me see if there's something else which I need to take. Yeah, Sneha Manjrekar has asked, what about domestic air travel and screening? And also, what if a person with normal viral be quarantined? No, so you see, so you cannot easily detect coronavirus just by a temperature scan. Anybody with a temperature scan has to be separated and then tested, especially with a high temperature like syndrome, has to be tested. And that person might take time actually to screen such people. So we are not really going to quarantine normal viral fever. It's actually dangerous to start doing that. When you quarantine, you should not put unhealthy people with healthy people or coronavirus infected people with non-coronaviral fevers. So I think that has to be taken care of. Then there are some links. Okay, somebody said you don't need face masks to prevent coronavirus. Is that true? Yes, that's true. You don't need face masks to protect yourself from coronavirus, but let's dig deeper. It's important to understand the science behind it. Number one, coronavirus from aerosol droplets, which is respiratory droplets, cough or sneezing, can travel up to a distance of about 3 feet. So if you're 3 feet away from anyone who's got a viral fever, you're safe. Well, you're more or less safe. You should still, probably make an extra distance. But wearing a mask is not going to keep you safe because of two reasons. First of all, much of the coronavirus infection happens in this way. Somebody sneezes, who's got coronavirus, those droplets fall on the table or a chair, or he uses a pen or a keyboard, and that coronavirus remains in that particular object, say a table, for a very long time. Then somebody else touches it, and then the virus droplets come to his healthy hands. Now his hands are now infected, but the infection cannot go inside your hand. It has to go in your system from here. So then this hand of a healthy person has to touch his face. It's either nose or mouth is where it finds entry. So you see, how do you prevent yourself from coronavirus is you can wear masks, but if you're wearing masks, remember that they will only protect you from a very small fraction of the cases and the ways in which you can get infected. The real good way to prevent yourself it would be to wash your hands, because hands are the primary source of the infection spreading. So you must wash your hands all the time. Just do it, like do it every hour. Set up an alarm, you know, every half an hour wash your hands. And properly, for 20 seconds, you should wash your hands or use an alcohol-based, alcohol-based solutions come. So do that. And if you're wearing a mask, if you are not well, however, if you are suffering from viral fever and you want to prevent this from spreading to others, it may be a coronavirus case, then you should wear a mask. Then it's really useful. Which brings me to another question, and again, I can't find where the name of the person, but it was a very good question. It was coming from somebody in Kerala, and he said that I have a viral fever for about a week, and he had dialed to the national coronavirus helpline, which has been set up, and he said nobody's answering. So what should I do now? So I can't really make the coronavirus helpline work, but I can tell you from what I know what you should do if you think you have coronavirus. So first of all, you should get medical attention. That's like number one thing to do. But in the meantime, before you consult your doctor or before you find medical help, here's what you can do to ensure that A, you stay healthy and you do not infect others, who would actually be useful to you, because when you are unhealthy, they'll be able to sort of serve you the best and take care of you. But at the same time, you don't want to infect them. So here's what you should do. First of all, children are the segment which you should definitely, stay away from. There's no reason for you to come in close proximity with children in case you're virally infected and you suspect you have coronavirus. Take your temperature regularly, drink fluids. Remember that coronavirus, like any other flu, sort of cures on its own, but the intermediary period of about 2 weeks, so it's about 2 weeks of infection which you'll have. In those 2 weeks is what you need to sort of take care of yourself. After that, most of the people have gone out healthy in 2 weeks, and they've lived, just like normal life. Nothing happens again. But let me also tell you that coronavirus can infect you twice. So just because you got it once doesn't mean that you've got immunity. So here's what you can do. You can also wear a mask, because an infected person, if he wears a mask, the droplets, when you sneeze or cough, will not travel over long distances. So that will help people sort of not get infected. Use your own utensils. Don't mix it up with the rest of the household or the rest of the people, because what you're touching is carrying an infection. So whatever you touch, ensure that it is the minimum number of products you are touching, and those products are not touched by others, just like you do in any other infection. I mean, in India, we know, this is something which is a common practice in viral fever back in my home in my days. So you should just follow the same things and just be careful and keep monitoring and definitely see a doctor. That's very important. Report it. There's nothing wrong in reporting it. It's just an infection which is severe. And in case you are a healthy person, the mortality rate is actually less than 1%, which is sort of similar to a normal flu. The real problem is children, old people, people with diabetes, respiratory and cardiac issues. Now I'm going to take some of the live questions which have come up. Let me just start from the beginning. Sorry, I have to use the same. This is a very homemade kind of a video I'm making. What are the symptoms? Are there? Is there? What are the symptoms? As there is already viral infection due to seasonal changes. This is Jyotsna Sharma asking. Well, there is no se there, so that's a very good question actually, because there is nothing very different. Coronavirus is also a viral kind of an infection. The symptoms are similar. So in case you get severe fever, headache, extremely high nasal discharges, breathing trouble, pneumonia can happen in complicated cases. Those are the things which, it's like a very bad viral fever. Do understand that viral fever is also sometimes very, very, complicated cases. So coronavirus is an extremely complicated case of viral fever. We yet do not have any special symbol which, any special symptom by which you can sort of distinguish between the two. So it's better to sort of get yourself checked for coronavirus if you think you have a severe viral fever. That's very important, especially if you've been traveling and if you've been exposed to people who are traveling. So that is then Nicolo is asking the same question. So Nicola, I think I've already addressed it. Prakhar is asking, we are not able to fight encephalitis. We are able to prepare to fight this virus even when China failed to. Well, you don't have a choice. Let's put it this way. You have what it is. You have this healthcare system. You and I are here. We have our social media to talk to each other. You have doctors. What you have in a matter of a few weeks, we can't increase the number of hospitals. So what we have is what we have, and you have to deal with it. So there's no question of saying we can't deal with it. I don't want to get this hopeless. We can deal with it. Remember, Prakhar, we also dealt with polio, we also dealt with bird flu, we also dealt with SARS. So we have dealt with it. So don't assume that, it's not that bad. We are a fairly good healthcare system. We are definitely better than Iran is. But if you say that things are lacking, yes, they are too. But let's sort of assume, and if something is lacking in the healthcare system, that must be compensated by awareness, which you and I should share. So you should share this video, you should share information from this video to your friends, and also, augment on it. I've done my research, you do your research too. Ponnuv G is asking, can we buy Tamiflu tablets and keep it in? So no, don't stock. Please do not stock anything. Don't stock Crocin, don't stock Dolo, don't stock anti-fever, don't stock masks or anything. You are going to put everybody at risk if you do that. Because most of the people, 99% people will have no infection of coronavirus. But 1% people will get it, perhaps, in the worst case scenario. And if you start stocking all the tablets of Crocin and Dolo and Tamiflu and masks and everything else from the pharmacy shop, and you will never use it because 99% people won't use it. But those 1% people who actually need it will never get it. So please don't, I know messages, a message came in the name of an American doctor to me in the morning on WhatsApp that stock up this tablet and stock up that tablet. Don't do that. In fact, this should be immediately stopped by the government. China, you know that what they're doing? In Wuhan, they banned the sale of anti-fever. So whatever their equivalent of Crocin tablet is there, they banned the sale. They said you come to a hospital, only then you'll get it, because they didn't want a rundown on the shops. And they wanted that people who are suspected coronavirus should come to a hospital so that they can detect them. So they did it. I think it's a high time that government restricts the sale of these things, because stocking should not happen at all. I mean, you keep whatever 6-10 tablets you keep in your house on a daily basis, just do that. It's even if it happens, you'll not have to eat hundreds of tablets. It's the same amount of tablet which you'll eat for the same amount of days. So please don't hoard tablets. Please do not listen to such messages. Please do not panic. Don't do a rundown on pharmacy shops for any kind of Tamiflu, or Tamiflu anyways is not going to work on your coronavirus. Manj Joyal has asking, Japan government is ignoring it completely. I live in Japan. Well, I don't know. Japan has shut down schools, that's what I know, and I'm not living in Japan, so you should talk to your government and tell them. And if the government is not doing something, you do something. How long the coronavirus survive in the atmosphere? Well, that's a very good question. We really don't know exact amount of time, but the Singapore Health Minister has talked about a few days. So Dulcio Almeida is asking this question. The Singapore Health Minister to his parliament gave an address about it, and to quote him, he said coronavirus can survive not in the atmosphere actually, but on surfaces. The droplets can survive with the virus for even days. So definitely, you can say a 2 or 3 days is the maximum, but a few hours, definitely. So that's like definite. So if somebody with the coronavirus sat in a cab, that cab can carry that infection for the rest of the day. So you see, that's what I'm trying to come to. If somebody from coronavirus was sitting in a plane chair or used a toilet in a plane, and somebody else uses that same handle or same in a train or something, then that handle will carry that coronavirus across several people. So that is something which you should know. So that's the reason why coronavirus is highly infective. Nicolo says again, I'm seeing in Kuwait there are 56 cases. To curb the virus, government has closed down schools till 15th of March. I hope we do this right now. And we also do something about the upcoming festival of Holi. I mean, I'm really scared. I love Holi. It's a fabulous festival, but I'm really scared about how will this virus explode on Holi. So if you are playing Holi, please play it with your family members. Don't go to social gatherings. Minimize the amount of exposure. It's for your own good. You will stay healthy. So it's just one time thing. Next year you can, play double Holi. But this year, please be careful with Holi, right? How do I save my 2-year son? Oh, let's not use the word save. You have to just protect him from the virus. Most children also, they survive easily through it. It's the really old people who are the most risk. But how do you protect your 2-year-old is by ensuring that, if there's any symptom of fever or coughing or any respiratory issue, you should definitely see a doctor. You should not expose him, to anything or anyone which may carry a virus, and you could be one of them. See, I know that, it's your son, and the mother's love is just the most eternal thing, but Right now, it's also a biological function where you can also become a source of infection for them. So just minimize that exposure. If you think that you've been traveling and you've been exposed to people who may have coronavirus or showed symptoms of viral fever, just ensure that you maintain your distance. 3 feet is, as I said, 3 feet is the distance you should maintain if somebody's infected and you are next to them. Even if it's a normal viral fever, you should maintain 3 feet. Ponu ji is asked Ponuvi ji is still asking Tamiflu tablets protect us. No, there's no evidence to suggest that. It's a different disease. Ramya Jennifer is asking, some of the naturopathy and homeopathy doctor are saying about their medicines for COVID. No, it's not true. Please, there's nothing proven of any medicine to cure coronavirus. But having said that, if you build your immunity either through Ayurveda or through homeopathy or any other pathy which you want, or just through healthy living, do that. Your immunity is going to, be your biggest ally in this. So anything which increases your immunity, you can try it. But please, I'm seeing advertisements that doctors are saying, I'll cure coronavirus, I'll prevent coronavirus. Please don't believe in all this. There is no cure as we know it. But anything which enhances your immunity in general, healthy living, proper sleeping, not exposing yourself to coronavirus infected zones is something which will help you. Sir, is UAE also infected? How risky is it to travel to UAE? Well, just as any other country, UAE is also sort of infected. And if you can avoid travel, feel free to do that. But if you still have to travel, just be cautious. It's not that it's extremely dangerous, but you do increase your risk of exposure to the virus if you are traveling. Because it's not just about UAE being infected. You're going to go in a plane where there'll be people from all kinds of nationalities and exposure zones. Imagine how did it happen in India. The second round of coronavirus first was in Kerala. The second round happened not, how did it happen? A group of tourists, and they didn't know, it's not their fault, but they were carrying that virus, they didn't know it, and they went on spreading it across India. So it just happens that you'll be in a tour group, you'll be in a plane which is full of people from Italy and China and whatnot, and who's carrying a virus, they don't know. So it's better not to, if you can avoid it, avoid it. If you still can't, then just be cautious. Carry a hand sanitizer. That would really help. Just use it also, not just carry it, but use it. Rishi Madan is asking, are people getting recovered from coronavirus? Yes, Rishi, they are. In fact, most of the people are. Most people have recovered, have gone home. In China, we have got a few thousand people, many more than those who have died. Many times of them have been cured, and they're healthy. But there are also, as I told you, there's also a case of people carrying double infection. So one infection followed by another round of coronavirus infection. Bulbul Singh is asking, what about Chennai residents? What do we need to prevent for? Well, as I said, nationwide, Bulbul, we need to close down schools. We need to ensure, in fact, I've been told Twitter has said that in India, I'm not sure, somebody told me, I'm not sure the name of the company, but there are companies now in India which are saying that coronavirus infection, because of the virus infection, you can work from home. So offices need to now, unnecessary people who can work from home, offices should say that, you can work from home. Government should incentivize it. You should, and once you do that, in a city like Delhi, I imagine even the metro loads will go down so that you can, between metro rides, you can deinfect the metros. And of course, because of deinfection, metros will slow down, but because less people will use it, you can still manage. And then hospitals should be ready in Chennai or anywhere else to take care of the coronavirus. Quarantine zones should be established, hopefully away from little away from the city, because you don't want a regular hospital to become a quarantine zone. No country does that. Americans have also taken the same route where they have set up quarantine zones which are separate from the rest of the town. Manjari Lakshmi is asking, taking tulsi or ginger can help? Tulsi and ginger are known to sort of increase your immunity through some research. So they can help you become more immune, but this is not a cure. So this is more like a, immunity will help you prevent the virus from spreading. But please don't take it like a sort of medical advice, because this is not a cure. Like any other, if you eat healthy, whether it's ginger, tulsi, or whatever else you eat healthy, it'll keep you healthy and viral infections are less likely to happen. But that's all. Is Hyderabad in danger? No, danger is a very strong and severe word. It's we have one known infection. I'm sure there will be a few which have been exposed. Some of them may be carrying infection. So as of now, it's not like a danger situation, but In 15-20 days, things may explode if we do not control it, and then it'll be really alarming. But to prevent that from happening, you have to act now, because you can't act then. If you have thousands of patients, clogging into hospitals, then your system will collapse. So you need to stop it right now. And that's why it's my request to the government, shut down schools, shut down offices, let people work from home. And that should be done just after Holi, just let Holi vacations end in summer vacations, So that's how we should do that. Using salt solutions will help the virus. Well, there's no rule, Simi, which says that, unfortunately. Nicolo says any superfood which can help us to protect us. Well, you'll come across a lot of advertisements which will now start claiming this, but please, this is not true. That's not true. Nicolo says our government should also make such calls ASAP. Yes, I hope, and that's why I said the Prime Minister could actually, use his Twitter channel to do this. Sorry, my phone has fallen. Right, sorry. Just a second. So this is it. I think I've sort of addressed all the questions. One question, Arpit is saying, how to stay safe in affected person if an affected person traveled from train to Bihar? What are the measures to take while traveling? Well, the same as you would take with any regular train or flight, where you will ensure that if you're using public amenities, you sanitize your hands after using it and before using it too. Stay away from somebody who you feel is infected. You should maintain a distance of 3 feet. Wash your hands. Don't touch your face. Don't touch your face. चेहरे को छूना छोड़ दीजिए. ऐसे नहीं बैठना आपको, ऐसे नहीं बैठना आपको, आपको ऐसे ऐसे नहीं करना, कुछ नहीं करना आपको, चेहरे पे हाथ नहीं लगाना, ठीक है? When will this virus end? Hopefully soon, Rahul. Let's see. Mudit is asking the question about Indian summer heat. Mudit, we've already talked about it. You can go through this video again. Warm water is the best preventive. No, please don't suggest such things, Mr. Jangid. You are a doctor, and please don't suggest that warm water is going to help cure the coronavirus. You could do anything which can, help you increase your immunity, but there's no cure for it. Let's admit it, there is no cure for it, and it goes on its own, but you just need to remain and survive through that 2 week period. Should we wash leg or only hand? Well, you can wash leg, but the problem is that the leg does not go to your face. So it's the hands which touch your face. So it's the hands, that's why which hand washing is more important than leg washing. But no harm in, being extra clean. सर, इन्फेक्ट होने के, जैसे शैली आस्किंग, इन्फेक्ट होने के कितने टाइम बाद सिम्टम दिखते हैं? एनी वेयर बिटवीन अबाउट अ वीक टू 2 वीक्स. एंड द प्रॉब्लम ये है शैली, कि इन्फेक्ट होने के बाद सिम्टम दिखने में तो 1-2 हफ्ते लग जाते हैं, बट उस पीरियड में भी वो इन्फेक्ट कर सकता है दूसरों को, तो उसको भी नहीं पता होगा, खांसी जुकाम भी नहीं है उसको. सो ये प्रॉब्लम है. फिर चलिए, बहुत अब्दुल रहीम सिंह बहुत दिन बाद बात कर रहे हैं. नहीं, कल भी किया था भाई, ठीक है. बेटर पीपल रिफ्रेन फ्रॉम, हाँ, बेटर पोन्नुवी जी सेइंग बेटर पीपल रिफ्रेन फ्रॉम गोइंग टू वॉच आईपीएल मैचेस. आई हैव ऑलरेडी कॉल्ड दैट, ऑल मैचेस, ऑल जो सीरीज चल रही थी इंडिया की, वी शुड हैव एक्चुअली स्टॉप्ड इट. वी आर एक्सपोजिंग पीपल टू सच थिंग. आई नो इट्स अ वेरी नॉन कमर्शियली, इट्स अ डिजास्ट्रस थिंग टू से फ्रॉम माई साइड, बट देन वेल, देर आर नो स्पॉन्सर्स फॉर दिस वीडियो, सो आई कैन, आई एम परफेक्टली फ्री टू से दैट. आई थिंक ऑल सच गैदरिंग्स ऑफ स्टेडियम्स, रिलीजन, इवन पोलिटिकल रैलीज, प्रोटेस्ट रैलीज, दे ऑल शुड बी बैंड. अब वक्त आ गया है कि, और बैन इसलिए नहीं कि हमें पसंद नहीं है या पसंद है, बल्कि इसलिए कि हमें सबको बचाना है. टेकिंग वाइटामिन सी टैबलेट्स और वाइटामिन सी सोर्स फूड विल हेल्प इन दिस. आर्य राजपूत इज सेइंग, वेल, वाइटामिन सी डज इंक्रीज योर इम्यूनिटी, बट दैट अगेन, दैट्स नॉट अ क्योर फॉर कोरोना वायरस, इट्स जस्ट अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ प्रिवेंटिव थिंग. अरे राजू, प्लीज शेयर ए यूट्यूब चैनल. चलिए, यूट्यूब पे भी डाल देंगे आर्या कभी, ठीक है? अभी एक वीडियो हम डाल रहे हैं यूट्यूब पे, उसको ठीक से प्रोड्यूस करके डालेंगे. ये तो लाइव चैट है, तो आई विल डू दैट, ठीक है? ओके, थैंक यू गाइस. आई विल कम अगेन टुमारो एंड वील टॉक मोर. एंड थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम. इट वॉज लवली टॉकिंग टू यू. कार्थिका हैज जस्ट सेंट अ कमेंट इंग्लिश. आई एम ट्राइंग टू बी इंग्लिश, बट वेर एवर द क्वेश्चन इज हिंदी, कार्थिका, आई ट्राई टू आंसर इन इन द सेम लैंग्वेज. इफ इज हिंदी, आई विल आंसर इन हिंदी. इफ इज इंग्लिश, आई विल आंसर इन इंग्लिश. Okay, so take care and stay healthy. I need to really rush somewhere, and I'll see you guys soon. And stay healthy, stay safe. Don't panic, don't stock anything, and just keep following the news and sharing with each other. Don't share rumors, please. Only share verified information. I only use verified information. There are hundreds of things which people have told me about coronavirus, which I wouldn't share unless it's verified. So thank you, and take care of all of you.